Kenny Lowry. And today we're just going to kind of go over some tips and care and usage, general questions that people ask me through the years after they've had their fountain for years. This fountain here has been, and we'll try to cover boulders and jars. Now this jar is the first disappearing fountain that we installed here about 15 years ago. It's been running ever since, had the heater in the basin, so it runs in the winter. We've had pictures of it with snow up to here on it. And we have that heater, so it keeps it from freezing. Now, once you put a heater in a basin, you're going to need to run that 24/7, because even though that heater's got a thermostat on it that kicks on when the water's 35 degrees, you need to keep that 35 degree water turning up through your jar. So if you turn it off at night, then you're not transferring that water. So you do have to run it, at that point, you're gonna run it 24/7. Another thing to look for in the winter, a lot of people have this question too. They'll say they think they have a hole in their basin. I've never had a basin have a hole in it. I've had people have their fountains for years, they'll call me and say they think they need a new basin. I always tell them, no you don't. That's my first response. I've never had a basin that had a hole in it. What they'll mistake that for a lot of time is that plume of water there, especially if it's windy, the wind will blow that plume out. So they'll start losing water a lot quicker than they normally do, so they'll think it's a hole. Another thing is debris, and this is what it most commonly is. After a while, you'll get enough debris on top of your basin, so you'll have to, and that'll clog up those holes that are in that screen and won't allow the water to pass back through. So what the water does then is comes on top of the screen and then runs out of the basin. So what you do is you remove the rocks, put them in a wheelbarrow, let them dry out, and this is the best way to do it. Trust me, I've been doing this 20 years. This is the best way to do it. Let them dry out, take a leaf blower, blow the debris out, turn them over with a shovel, blow the debris out, turn them over with a shovel, blow the debris out. Just keep doing that. The last thing you can do is wash them. If you wash them right away, it's just going to cause the debris to stick to the rocks. You're not going to get it out of there. You have to wash each rock individually. It's a lot easier to do it in a wheelbarrow with a leaf blower and blow the debris out that way. Also, after that long of running, you might get kind of a scale buildup, mineral deposits. Now this jar's been here 15 years, been running 15 years, and in that 15 years we've probably got 2 hours worth of maintenance. If you turn this off and let it dry off, it's going to be full of calcium deposits. They don't show up when it's wet, so it kind of goes away when it's wet. If you want to try to clean that, you can use that, I think it's called CLR, you can use that to get some of it off of there. But this jar, I've just let it run all that time. I don't think it's an unsightly thing. Now if it were dried out, it would be, but with the water running over, it's not. Basin cleaning. If you wanted to, you can clean this basin. This basin's never been cleaned, it's been here 15 years. Directly under a crepe myrtle tree, messy tree you can put in your yard. Beautiful tree, but messy tree, drops blooms and leaves, seeds all the time. If you wanted to, you could clean this. It's probably a couple inches of sludge in the bottom of this after 15 years. And that sludge is settled, so it really doesn't become an issue. In that 15 years, that 2 hours worth of maintenance is clean the intake on the pump. So you have to take that debris will finally work its way through the screen, and I just basically pull the rocks away, lift out the panel for your pump access, grab the debris, and just throw it out. Have to do that about once a year. The first time we installed it, we only had to do it after about the third or fourth year, but now it's a yearly thing. Enough of that debris is getting in there, we have to clean the pump up. It takes about 2 or 3 minutes. So fill it up. We fill it up with a garden hose. A lot of people want to know how much to fill it up. We fill it up until it's completely full. You can top it off if you want, but we fill it up till it's actually running over and then we turn it off. We need to use a garden hose to do that. You can actually use an automatic fill, kind of works like a miniature float on your toilet. We do sell those and they mount into your basin and you can use that, but we just have so many fountains here, we just pull the garden hose around. Mostly when we lose water is the wind blowing that plume. It's not evaporation, it's the wind blowing the plume of water. In the wintertime, we turn that plume down, so that it has less aft to catch up, because wind is when we get more of that in the winter than the other time. Cleaning the jar. A lot of people want to know if you use your Fountech, the water added to keep the water clear, 1 drop per gallon per week. You don't have to use full dosage. You can use about half or three quarter dosage. So depending on the gallons is how much you're going to use. If you don't use it, the water's still going to stay clear most of the time, but you'll get algae buildup on the fountain feature itself. On these jars, to clean it, soft bristle brush. What we'll do is use it as just a burlap bag and we'll wipe it off. Comes right off. Glaze is melted glass, so it doesn't stick on there very well. So we just kind of wipe it off. If you got a boulder or something like that, turn the fountain off, let it dry out. When it dries out, it'll kill the algae. You can still use a soft bristle brush if you want, but we find it just turn it off, let it dry out. And you take a leaf blower, or if you want to do a pressure washer, but a leaf blower and kind of blow it off, blow the dry debris off. I'm looking at some cheat notes here, because these are questions I get asked a lot. Covered most of that. How do you know when it needs water? If you see your plume of water going down about, you know, less than it normally is, you probably either need water or you need to clean the intake on that pump. If you see air bubbles in your water, that probably is telling you again, you need to add water. That's what I do. My eyes are tuned to this. When I walk around here, if I see a fountain not running the way it's supposed to, I know it needs water, it needs to clean the intake on the pump. So look for those kinds of things. Don't run your pump dry. You'll burn your pump up. That pump is cooled when the water passes through it. So you don't want to run it dry. And cleaning the basin, if you do want to clean that basin, you're going to remove the rocks, of course. You're going to remove the fountain feature. You'll take the basin out, just dump all the sludge out, wash it out, put it back in. If you just need to clean that screen intake, just take your rocks off, take a shop vac, screen to clean, kind of suck the debris off of that screen. You don't need to take the whole basin out at that point. I guess you could run the water out and maybe use a shop vac and without removing the basin with that, and that way you wouldn't have to remove the fountain feature itself. Now these are just a few helpful tips that people will call me about. We are here to answer any questions. That's one of the advantages of us. I've been doing this a long time. We have a whole lot of fountains here. You can't ask me anything that I haven't already answered. So hopefully this will help you, and if you have any other questions, let me know. You can always reach me at 540-948-2239 or email me Kenny@southerngracevA.com.